Assalamu alaikum students, welcome back to English class. Open your books to page number 14. So in the last lecture, we read and discussed this story. Now we'll be doing all the exercises of it in our textbooks. So you have to make sure you read the story, just so you can easily ye questions kare. So let's start with learn to read. Number 1. Complete the following sentences in your own words. So these are all from the story. So we need to test our knowledge agar hum story ko samjhe. Part A. Gulliver could feel thin dash all over his body. What could he feel, students? Yes, thin pieces of string. So you will write in this blank, pieces of string. Good. Part B. He was unable to see the things that were moving because his dash to the ground. So you can see his answer first paragraph mein hi hai aapke story ke. My arms and legs and my long thick hair were tied to the ground. Now you have to write in your own words. Question mein likha hua hai. Write in your own words. So you can say arms, legs and hair were tied to the ground. Or you can just write hair were tied to the ground. So in part B's blank you will just write hair was tied. Good job. Now come to part C. He was very surprised by the dash of the men. Very easy. This answer is of course size. Size of the men. Remember how he kept saying little men, little people. It shows that he was so surprised by their size that they were so small. So the answer will be size. Part D. The spears could not injure him because his jacket dash. This is also very easy. It clearly mentioned that his jacket was made of a strong material. The answer is because his jacket was made of strong cloth. In part D, the blank is a bit short, but the whole answer will be was made of strong cloth. Part E, they realized that he was hungry because he pointed dash to his mouth. He pointed to his mouth. Aur phir unko pata chala tha ki usse bhook lagi hai. So in the blank you'll write to his mouth. Now number 2, why were the Lilliputians able to tie up Gulliver? So students, question 2 ka answer kahan bhi straightforwardly likha nahi hua. You have to read inside the lines and figure it out. Okay, you have to think. So let's see. Before they say Gulliver continues the story, kya hume bataya gaya hai? That he is so tired when he's done swimming. He's lucky to swim to safety. He reaches dry land. He is so hungry. He's so tired. He falls asleep at once. He does not know, but he has landed in Lilliput. So students, what does this mean? Ki he must have fallen asleep for a very long time for these little people to tie him up. So the exact answer is for part 2. The Lilliputians were able to tie up Gulliver because he had been very tired after swimming to safety and had fallen into a deep sleep for several hours. Now question number 3. List the things in the passage that proved that the Lilliputians were very small. This is super easy because humme bar bar bataya gaya hai little people, little men. So this is super easy. Paragraph ko agar aapne phir se padha ho, then you will know exactly what to write. So students, is answer mein aapko at least 5 cheeze apni list mein likhni hai. Yahan 7 mention ki gayi hai. Number 1, the men were only 6 inches tall. Ye exactly hume passage mein bataya gaya hai ki unki inches, unki size kya thi. So you can write that. Several of them could climb over Gulliver, around 40 at first and later 100. Just second part, it's not as important, lekin the main point is ki wo chal rahe the Gulliver ke upar. And not only just one person, so many. That's like such a big number. It's a very big number, 40, 100. So that's another good point. Some got hurt when they jumped off his body. Now of course they're so small, or under his body wouldn't be that big. So the fall must be very small. The jump will be very small. Even smaller than when you jump off your bed. Lekin tabhi bhi they got hurt. Their arrows were the size of needles. Now you must have seen in movies at least ki actual bow and arrow ki equipment kitni bari hoti hai. But Gulliver compared it to needles. Suiyan bahut choti hoti hai, right? Jo kapre stitch karne ke liye kitni choti hoti hai. And they were compared with arrows. So of course unki weapons bahut chote the. They built an 18-inch high platform. Matlab, they were able to only build this small platform aur unke liye ye kafi tha. They needed to put ladders against him to climb on him with the food. Jaise maine pehle mention kiya ki they fell off his body and they were hurt. Similarly, unko climb karne ke liye bhi ladder ki zarurat thi. Wo itne chote hain. Gulliver could eat 3 loaves of their bread at a time. Matlab, loaves of bread sirf ek piece nahi hota. It's a whole loaf. Jo puri bread ka hame milta hai, it was all of that. वो इतना छोटा है कि उसने तीन खा लिए. हम कैसे एक लोफ को इतने दिनों चलाते हैं, राइट स्टूडेंट्स? सो दैट मीन्स इनकी चीज़ें इतनी छोटी हैं. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, कम टू लर्न टू रीड टू. सो इन दोनों क्वेश्चंस के आंसर्स आई कैन टेल यू एनीथिंग बिकॉज दे आर अबाउट यू, अबाउट योर फीलिंग्स एंड थॉट्स, एंड यू विल राइट दीज योर सेल्फ. सो आई जस्ट एक्सप्लेन दैम टू यू. Number one, what would you do if you woke up and found that you had become a giant? Talk about your feelings and the things that you would or would not be able to do. So now you have to explain ki imagine agar aap ek din uthe neend se and you see that you have become a giant, right? So you have to talk about your feelings. Aapko apne feelings ke baare mein baat karni hai and jo cheeze aap kar sakte hain aur nahi kar sakte. So you will just talk about that, make a paragraph and just list your feelings. Just imagine ek story aap likh rahe hain, okay? Number two, what do you think Gulliver will do next? How can you find out whether you have guessed right? So first of all, what do you think Gulliver will do next? Yep, khud likhenge. Because this is all according to you, right? This is, there's no correct or wrong answer. Then how can you find out if you have guessed right? Of course, you can read the book. Because as mentioned, this book written by Jonathan Swift is a complete book. Ye sirf ek choti story nahi hai. So you can mention that. That is your second question's answer. But first part, what do you think? You will write this yourself. Also, I forgot to mention ki ye dono parts ab apni notebook mein karenge. After your title page, after your hard words and word meanings, you have to do this yourself in your notebook. Aap yahan nahi likh sakte, of course, there is not enough space. Maine bola, you will write a paragraph, so you will write a paragraph in your notebook. Now turn the page. Now page 15 per ek exercise hai, learn words. Part 1. A list of words from the text is given below in column C. Write down words and phrases that can be used to describe them. Now column C mein you can see these words are given. Ab hume inko explain karna hai. The words in column A should be from the text. Column A mein words hone chahiye text mein se. So you will just copy paste jo words yahan se hum describe karenge. And the ones in column B should be your own. Lekin column B mein hum khud ke koi bhi words likh sakte hain, lekin tabhi bhi column C ko explain karte waqt. The first one has been done for you. Let's see ki inka example kya hai. Part A. Column C mein kya diya gaya hai? Tall. Yahan tall hum kaise explain kar sakte hain? By sizes, right? So column A, hamare text mein se humne liya hai 6 inches. And column B, jo hum khud likh rahe hain, they wrote 5 feet. Now let's see what your sample answer can look like. Okay, now the second word in column C is hair. Now column A mein hum likhenge what will explain here, what will describe here, lekin from the text. So let's see what can we write. We can write long, thick. Because if you remember first paragraph mein hi, what did he explain his hair by? What did he describe them by? My long, thick hair were tied to the ground. So you can write long or thick. In mein se ek word likh le. Now in column B we will write our own word. Hum apna khud ka koi bhi word likh sakte hain, not from the text. So hum long ka opposite likh sakte hain, which is short, right? Short hair. Or you can write black, black hair. You can write any color, brown hair, blonde hair, red hair, jo bhi. Moving on to the third word, it is peace. Now how can we describe peace from the text? Yes, he used the word thin, a thin piece of string. Now let's see in column B, we will write our own word. Now you can write anything to describe peace. Ek piece chota ho sakta hai, bara ho sakta hai, lamba ho sakta hai. So you can write long, you can write short, you can write large, small, anything jo ek piece ko describe kar sake. Piece kya hota hai? Ek hissa. Now, arm is the fourth word. So in column A for the word arm, hum likh sakte hain left arm. Kyunki ye bar bar he was explaining, I was tugging my left arm. Maine apni left arm ko pull kar raha tha. So you can write left. And then for column B, you can write right arm. Because text mein he didn't mention about his right arm, but you can in column B. Then your fifth word is people. Now, what did he describe people by? In the text, yes, little. So in column A you will write for part E, little. But then what about your column B? You can write anything, any word you want to describe people by. People is log. So log kaun hote hain? They're gentle, they're kind, they're tall. So you can write any of this word, any of these words. Large is not a good word for people. It's better to write tall. Now for part F, the word in column C is hurt. We have to describe hurt. So in the text, they said badly hurt because they explained the people that they were badly hurt but they fell. So that is for column A. Then what can you write for hurt by your own self? These are all adjectives, right, students? We are using adjectives to describe these words they're giving us in column C. In column A, we are using adjectives in the story. In column B, we are using adjectives from our own mind. So for part F, what can you write from your own mind for hurt? Deeply hurt, seriously hurt, barely hurt. Barely hurt means ki bahut kam chot lagi. They were barely hurt. Mujhe jaise kuch laga hi nahi, right? Then for voice, what can we write? This is part G. In the story, for voice, they used high. High voice mein, the little people spoke, right? Clear voice also was used. So you can use either of them. Here come to column B. What can you write yourself? You can write the opposite of it, soft. You can write a similar word to high, which is loud. Right, loud voice. These two words were not used in the story, so you can use it in column B. Just make sure ki aap jo bhi column B mein likh rahe hain, they weren't used in the text. And in column A, make sure ki aap text mein se hi le rahe hain. Now come to the next one, needles. This is very easy. They said sharp needles. So column A mein you will write sharp. Then for column B, what can you write? You can write anything. You can write long, long needle, fine needle. Then come to cloth. In column A, what can we write? Strong cloth. Yes, remember, the spears couldn't go through his cloth because it was strong. Couldn't go through his jacket because it was made of a strong cloth. Next, for column B, anything you can write for cloth, you can write soft, soft cloth. You can write thick because in winter, like we wear thick cloth, yes. Then the last one is platform. Very easy. In the text, it was little, a little platform. For yourself, you can write anything, high, large, wooden. So that is how to solve number one. Now let's go to number two. Note how the word travel is used in these sentences. His job included a lot of travel. My hobbies are music and travel. The story is based on Gulliver's travels. The only time travel is used in the plural is when we talk about the time spent in visiting foreign countries. What did they mean by plural? More than one. Read the following sentences and correct them if they are wrong. So all you have to do is figure out ki travel ka singular use karna hai ya plural. And they are also letting you know ki plural sirf tab use karte hain when we're talking about the time spent in visiting foreign countries. Matlab jab hum bahir ki mulkon mein jaate hain aur wahan waqt spend karte hain. So let's see. Part A, Pakistan must develop its travel industry. This is correct because we are not talking about the time spent in visiting foreign countries. Part B, this is a special pass that allows unlimited travels. Wrong. Yahan travel is a noun. Again, there it's just like part A. Hum time spent ke baare mein nahi baat kar rahe. So part B is wrong. Hame yahan travels ki end mein s nahi lagana. It should be singular. Inhone galti se plural kar liya hai. So you will put an X on the wrong one and you will write the correct sentence without S. Good job. Or part A mein, you will just put a tick. Part C, I enjoy train travels more than air travels. Part C is also, of course, wrong. We are not talking about the time spent in visiting. We are just talking about the enjoyment of someone that they like train travel more than air travel. So hume yahan se S hatana hai after travel. So the answer will be, I enjoy train travel more than air travel. Put a X next to it and write the correct answer. Part D, they say that space travel will become pretty common. Correct. This is perfectly correct. Part E, she has to see a travel agent and plan her trip. Correct. So the only wrong ones over here were part B and C. So students, notice how is question mein all these sentences will have singular travel. Kyunki none of them are used in this way. None of them are used in talking about time spent in visiting foreign countries. They are all using in other ways. So sab aapke answers honge singular. Now we are done with exercise reading and words. We will do the rest in the next lecture. Until then, make sure to do all of this work. See you next time. Allah Hafiz.